Hello class, this is ELE2213 and the subject is integrated circuit technologies, and we are specifying the fan in. In the last video we talked about fan in and fan out. Here is a review. A chip can operate in two positions. When the output voltage is high, the current flows out of the first chip and is into the second chip. When the output of the chip is low, then the current comes out of the second chip and flows into the first chip. The names we give these two options are current sourcing and current sinking. We just finished completing the example with regards to what happens when the output voltage is high. Now we will complete the example when the output voltage is low. When the output voltage is low, we will focus on these two measurements, the I output low and the I input low. The I output low specifies, as you can see, a maximum value. That means it is telling you how much current that it can receive without becoming damaged. The I input low is a number that tells you how much it's actually using when it's connected to that gate. And you can see that number is lower than the maximum. And that's good because the current that's being used has to be less than the limit. But it also tells you that you can probably add more gates until you reach the limit. And that's the number that we need to find. So we have a maximum value of 16 milliamps. And each gate only uses 1.6 milliamps. After we take those two numbers and we divide them, we'll get the number of 10. That tells us that we can continue connecting more and more gates until we reach the number 10, which is the maximum number of gates that we can connect to this single gate in the low state. In the previous example, our fan out was 10. And now our fan in, or when the output voltage is low, is also 10. So if we're making a design for this system, we know that we can only connect up to 10 gates for both the high condition and the low condition, so that not to damage the chip. Now let's look at a couple of examples using the data sheet. The first example says, if we have a chip and we've already measured the data sheet for that chip, and it told us that the I output high is 0.24 milliamps, and we decided to connect that chip to the 74LS chip. How many of these gates can be connected? Well, we have the I output high 0.24, so we need the I input high. Here we are. Now, there are two options here. The most logical option would be this one, simply because we're using TTL chip. And we know the voltage into that chip will not be 7 volts. So that means our number that we would look for would be 20 microamps. Remember, this is a maximum number of source. So if I convert that to micro, that will be 240 microamps. Now, each gate will use 20 microamps of current. So if we take 240 divided by 20, we'll get 12. So that gives us 12 gates that we can use before we cause any problems to the chip. So the fan out for this system would be 12. Now let's look at another example. Here, we're going to assume that the I input low for that same TTL chip is 80 microamps. And it's connected to that same chip, 74LS. And we want to know how many gates can be connected. Well, this is a low condition, so we know the current will flow out of the second gate into the first gate. And this is the current being used by each gate. So we need to know the I output low. We're using the 7400, so it tells us 8 milliamps. So that means the maximum is 8 milliamps, which effectively is 8,000 microamps. If we take 8,000 and divide that by 80 microamps, okay, that'll give us 100. So the fan in for this chip is 100. However, in the first example, we only got 12. So 12 is a lower number, so that means we can only go up to 12, because we have to consider both the output condition for high and the output condition for low. So it appears that the output condition for high is limiting our design to 12 connections. All right. This is the subject of fan in and fan out, which is a question that possibly can come on your exam. Thank you.